Is Halo Infinite's in-game store ethical or unethical?
Well, at the very least, we can start this discussion today because we got a glimpse of it in the technical preview. Let's break it all down.
Hi, my name's SDDog, and today's video is going to be a little bit different because I typically write out a script and do a nice little narration, but today is going to be a little bit more ranty and unscripted just because I feel like I need to get this video out sooner rather than later, because I think people need to really start this discussion as soon as possible when it comes to the in-game store. And let's talk about that. So I got into the technical preview after being in the pending gang for like 3 hours, so shouts out to all my pending gang members. I know the struggle. So after finally getting in, I knew that I was gonna make a video about cosmetics. If you've been following my channel, you know that my Halo content kind of centers around multiplayer customization and cosmetics because, I don't know, it's just really important to me and I think it'll be really important to the game once we get into it. So while I have other thoughts about the technical preview in general, I will be specifically concentrating on the moral discussion around what 343 presented to us as an in-game store so far in this technical preview. I'll probably make a couple more videos on this, just about more general thoughts and listing out other cosmetics, but let's get to the discussion about whether or not what we saw was ethical or not. And I have some very strong opinions arguing that right now it's not in a place where it should be. So I want to preface all of my following criticisms with this. I acknowledge that Halo Infinite will be a free-to-play game. This is not a premium experience if you're looking to skip the campaign, right? So while I acknowledge that, that doesn't mean free-to-play games can do no wrong, okay? All right, now that we got that out of the way, let's go back to my story. So I got into the game. First thing I did was check out the store, and I immediately looked at the battle pass because I was expecting there to be a preview to get a good idea of it, right? And I was totally fine with this. Everything was okay. There were coatings, armors, XP boosts, a bunch of other good stuff sprinkled throughout the pass. It looked very content rich and compelling, so I have absolutely no gripes here. So looking through the battle pass, everything looks fine. But then I back out to this menu, and this is where I have a problem. So this menu looks very eerily like a lot of other free-to-play games, but what comes to my mind, because I don't play a lot of free-to-play games, is probably Black Ops 4. And Black Ops 4 was probably like the worst game of like the last decade, in my opinion, in terms of like predatory monetization tactics. It looks pretty identical to their store in the sense that there is a battle pass, and then outside of that there is a separate store where separate cosmetics are sold outside of this pass. And this is where I kind of have an issue, and I take umbrage especially with these two screenshots right here where it says daily. There wasn't a specific description here. I don't know if that was deliberate or not, where it says daily. Is this the promoted cosmetic of the day? Is this something that you'll have to earn within 24 hours by paying or by doing some crazy challenge? This is something that you just pay straight up for these, because they gave you 3,000 credits, which is the premium currency in the store right when you get into the technical preview. And I immediately bought these. That's how I know it's confirmed that you buy these with the premium currency. And this is where I have a problem, because if you make it like Black Ops 4, what I didn't like about it was that, well, first off, that game was a full price game, and then it had a pretty predatory monetization system. So this is not apples to apples, but what I didn't like about Black Ops 4 was that you had the battle pass, which already was very grindy. And then on top of that, you had all of these other cosmetics that were not part of the battle pass. They were just things that you had to buy in a very limited amount of time. And what I don't like, and what I think we should all push back against, is the idea that you have to buy or earn certain cosmetics within a very short amount of time. I think that is very underhanded, and I don't think that should belong in Halo. I think rewards shouldn't be fear of missing out, shouldn't be FOMO. They should be something that people enjoy working toward. It's not something that people are stressed out to get. And from this screenshot, it just feels like 343 343 is putting that out there as like a feeler. And I'll just say, before you come at me and say like, yo, SD Dog, this is literally just a technical preview. This is not even a beta. What are you getting so riled up about? And my response to that is, yes, I know it's a technical preview, but because it's a technical preview, we should be getting riled up about this. We should be pushing back against things that we don't like. They literally said to us, this is the time to give us feedback. This is the time to tell us if you don't like something, if you do like something, right? So this is the time to do it, not at launch. Otherwise, if we don't communicate, this system will probably just be put into the final product. They're putting out feelers right now. They're seeing what will people tolerate. I don't think people should tolerate this. I think the right thing for them to do, if you want to do a battle pass, make things earnable outside of that battle pass, like in campaign, in multiplayer, in academy, sure, that's completely fine. I'm even okay with them putting in outside cosmetics. I'm even okay with them doing this. Just in particular, the time limit is what I have a problem with. I think that really gives a sense of like, I have to go back to this game. I have to go back and do this challenge or buy this. Like, I have to do it, not because the game's fun, but because if I don't, I'm gonna miss out. And I mean, I guess it's a whole nother thing if they do this, but then they eventually come out with that cosmetic way down the line in some other capacity. But I think they need to be up in front about what they're doing in their store. They should be giving us a response back at some point after this and say, hey, we heard your feedback loud and clear. We heard that you don't want us to put these timed cosmetics in here. We hear you loud and clear. How about we're gonna still do it, but these cosmetics won't be locked away forever. If that's the case, okay. That's a whole nother story. But it looks like they're wanting to do exclusive cosmetic sales outside of the Battle Pass. But I said this before in my previous video, their Battle Pass system is probably like the most pro-consumer model out there. I have to give them props, credit where credit's due, but we should also call a spade a spade. I don't think this is right. Yes, it could change, but this is the time to speak up about it, not at launch. Around launch, they're gonna be very much focused on delivering us new content, fixing bugs, doing fundamental changes to their monetization systems is probably something that they're not going to do after launch, unless there is a huge backlash. So those things are my main concerns. I know Halo Infinite will not be Black Ops 4, but this very much reminds me of that system, and that is a big reason why I kind of stopped playing, because I felt like I was just missing out on too much stuff. And then aside from that, going down here, I also kind of have a little bit of an issue with the XP and challenge swaps, specifically the XP boosts that you can purchase. So right here, it says like 100 credits. So you can go in and buy an XP boost. I personally think that is kind of just a way to get past the grind. And if what I'm speculating is true, this seems to be contradictory to 343's statements about not wanting their game to feel like a quote, part-time job. Then 343, why are you suggesting on the main store page the sale of boosts? If you're confident that your battle pass is not going to be too grindy, if you're trying to be the paragon of the free-to-play model, then show us at launch. Go all in. Show the industry what free-to-play video games should strive to be. And listen, it's not like I'm against the idea of XP boosts, because they're not going to give you an advantage. They're going to apply toward your rank and probably the battle pass that has to do with cosmetics, right? All I'm saying is that I think it gets a bit weird if people are buying and stacking up on these XP boost to fly through the battle pass, because again, that would be indicative of a manufactured lengthy grind. Make these boosts earnable in campaign, matchmaking, academy, battle pass, whatever. Why sell these en masse in the store unless there is an ulterior motive? Another comparison I can make to this is in PUBG, as they did something similar to this where you could literally use premium currency to skip tiers in their paid battle pass. It's something I still disagree with, but at least I almost respect it a bit more than the idea of keeping a subtleness around the XP boosts in Halo Infinite, because at least in PUBG's case, they're being straight up and honest about it. Again, obviously nothing is confirmed in Infinite right now. This is just a tech preview, but I'm catching a whiff of where the wind is going, and hopefully we can make a stand here and state that we don't want this to be a reality when Infinite comes out. Hopefully, 343 can communicate with us what function exactly the XP boosts have in the store, but I think the practice of just straight up buying XP boosts is kind of weird to me. For some reason, I just can't get past it. But I think those are like my main concerns. I know this was super ranty and unscripted, but again, super important to me. I'm gonna try to send this video to 343 somehow, because I know they are scrubbing through YouTube to see people's feedback. So definitely leave what you feel down below, because I think it's really important of how this game is shaped before launch. And I think this is something that's definitely not a huge game changer if a lot of people were to protest against specifically the timed exclusives and the XP boosts. I think that's something that they can fix pretty quick, and it's not something that's something you don't have to overhaul the whole game for. But aside from that, I really like the cosmetics that we've seen so far. In game, it looks really fun. And then again, I'll put out another video that covers all the cosmetics and kind of like my general thoughts about the technical preview. So far, I'm liking it, guys. Just not this part of the store. And yes, I know, technical preview, but now's the time to speak up. That's all my thoughts for today. Please comment down below. Like the video if you did. Subscribe if you want to see more content just like this, and more to come very soon, guys. So appreciate it. Appreciate your time, and I'll see you in the next video.